Very often people have strong ethical intuitions about how water supply should operate. Let's look just a bit at how this influences the actual supply of water. It's a common view that water is somehow part of the common heritage of mankind, or that it belongs to the planet, or that it belongs to nature. And thus, as a result, many people have the ethical intuition that water should not be made an object of private property. It seems wrong that an individual or corporation could somehow capture or corral a body of water or a flow of water and say, "This is mine, this is not yours." Imagine that you would be riding a camel in the desert and be very thirsty and need water to live, and you would come across an oasis, and some private individual would own that water and say, "If you want this water, you have to pay me $1 million, $1 billion, whatever." To many people, that simply seems wrong, and that's part of this intuition that water should not be the subject of private property. It's not my goal here to discuss whether this intuition is right or wrong per se, but there is an economic angle to the intuition. Once we take something like water or food, and we say that it cannot become private property, that a corporation or an individual cannot charge for supplying that water or supplying that food, what do we typically get? We typically get a shortage or an extreme scarcity, because no one has the incentive to supply that water, to bring it to your home, to make sure that the water supply is replenished and maintained and looked after. So an economic perspective on these normative intuitions, it's a little more pragmatic. It doesn't try to take on or battle the intuitions directly, but it simply points out that the end of supplying more people with better water and cheaper water will in some circumstances be done better when we in fact allow private property rights in water. So what's the alternative to allowing someone to exercise a property right or dominion over a water resource? Well, it would mean that it's very hard to get systematic institutional control, maintenance, and management of a water supply. You could imagine an open public well where people go to the well and carry water back to their homes, and water is more expensive and maybe less clean and maybe less good for people's health. So there is a pragmatic argument for allowing a considerable degree of property rights when it comes to the supply of water, even though I think we all understand the intuition that water is in part, in some manner, the common heritage of mankind.